Hello everyone, my name is Harsanjam Singh. Today I'm gonna talk about soil water balance equation. In this, I'll define what exactly is soil water balance equation, mathematical representation of soil water balance equation, its parameters, and finally I'll use soil water balance equation to solve a problem related to it. So let's first talking about what exactly is soil water balance. It is a concept used to describe the movement and distribution of water within the soil system. The soil water balance equation is a fundamental tool used in hydrology and agriculture sciences to understand the movement and availability of water in soil. By calculating the soil and water balance, researchers and farmers can determine the water needs of crops, evaluate the potential impacts of drought or excessive rainfall, manage irrigation practices to improve water use efficiency. So, soil water balance equation also helps in making estimates of parameters which influence the amount of water added, removed, or stored in a given volume of soil during a given period of time. Here is the equation that defines soil water balance. It represents the parameters which contribute to the soil water storage. So, very first, we have precipitation. Over here, we can see in the figure that precipitation is caused due to precipitation is the rain that adds water to the soil, right? And second is irrigation, another parameter with the help of which we are able to add water to soil. And further comes runoff, and then comes drainage, evaporation, and transpiration. These are the parameters due to which there is subtraction of water from the soil. That's how the moisture is lost from the soil. Finally, we are able to get the change in soil water storage using all the parameters. From out of all these, precipitation and irrigation are the ones that add water to the soil, and rest four that we are able to see runoff, drainage, evaporation, and transpiration. These are the factors that are responsible for decrease in soil water. Further moving ahead, here is an example question which is used to in which a soil water balance equation is used. So here is a farmer who is using soil moisture sensors to guide his irrigation decisions. So he has to decide how much of irrigation he have to give to his field. The parameters or the amounts, the values that are given to us are initial volumetric water content, depth of the root zone, final volumetric water content, the losses due to evaporation, and the loss of water due to runoff. So what we have to find is amount of irrigation that we have to apply to the field. Moving ahead, here is the solution. In this first step of the solution, we are using the main soil water balance equation. Over here, we are able to see all the parameters that are contributing to addition of water in the soil and which are responsible for a reduction of soil moisture, and they are compared with soil water storage, change in soil water storage. So in the question, we are just given runoff and evaporation losses. That is about 15% runoff loss and 10% evaporation losses. By solving this equation, there is just some simple mathematical hit and trial, and we'll be able to get the irrigation in comparison to change in soil water storage. Further moving on to the second step, we were given final volumetric water content, and the initial volumetric water content along with it was the depth of root zone. So by solving this equation, we'll be able to find the change in soil water storage. That is, we get an answer of 3 inches. And further taking both these solutions of the first step and the second step, when we compare them both, we'll be able to get the irrigation that is 4 inches. Over here, we just compare the left-hand side with the right-hand side, and that's how we got the answer of irrigation that is 4 inches of irrigation, which the farmer has to apply to his fields. And that's it. Thank you so much.